إن الله بصير بالعباد ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله الذي ذكره شرف للذاكرين وشكره فوز للشاكرين وطاعته نجاة للمطيعين والصلاة والسلام على أكرم الأنبياء والمرسلين شفيع المذنبين خاتم النبيين رحمة للعالمين بالقاسم محمد اللهم صل على وأهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين لا سيما بقية الله في الأراضين صاحب العصر والزمان خليفة الرحمن إمام الإنس والجان الذي بيمنه رزق الورى وبه ثبتت الأرض والسماء اللهم عجل فرجه الشريف ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا وأخطأنا ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين أما بعد فقد قال الله وهو أصدق القائلين وقوله الحق بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم أفغير دين الله يبغون وله أسلم من في السماوات والأرض طوعا وكرها وإليه يرجعون صلوا على النبي اللهم صل With the help of Allah, the gracious, the merciful, we are talking about need of religion. At the beginning, we have expressed our feelings in regards to the situation in which we are existing, no matter in this world where you are existing. Always we hear things which are not relate to the religion, always against the religion. So we, our children, our future generations are growing in such an environment where religion has been forsaken, it has been forgotten. So we have to remind, this is the time exclusive in regards to Imam Hussain alayhi salatu wasalam. And it is very beautiful to know the ziyarat of Waritha we recite every Thursday night. And when we recite Shahada, ziyarat of Shahada e Karbala, Assalamu alaikum ya ansara deenillah. Please, those who are, you can go under the, inshallah, the rahmat of Allah is coming. We cannot resist the rahmat, inshallah. Salawat wa rahmat wa ala Muhammad. One salawat again, please, if you don't mind. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad wa ajjil farajahum. I'm talking about the environment in which we are existing, we are living today. It's a very brutal environment in regards to religion. And when we say in ziyarat of waritha for shuhada-e Karbala, assalamu alaikum, ya ansar deenillah. So who is deen here? Imam Hussain is not a person. Imam Hussain here is deen. That's the reason Khwaja Ajmeri is not talking about his own feelings when he expresses Deen Ast Hussain and Deen Pana Ast Hussain. Hussain, Imam Hussain is Deen. So Alhamdulillah, we follow the path of Ahlul Bayt alayhim salatu wasalam. We believe the perfect path, a perfect sirat which leads to the salvation and the success of this world, the world to come. Okay, thank you. Salawat for you. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad. We discuss the matter, why should we talk about religion on the first day? The answer to the question is, there is no escape from religion. All of us, we do have a way of life we lead. That way of life is called religion, deen. And we have given example from the Quran. Quran mentions Kuffar Quraysh, non-believers of Mecca in the pre-Islamic history. Quran recognizes their way of life as a deen. Lakum deenukum waliya deen. Yesterday I was talking about two perspective of life, and we don't have any other third one. If there is third one, it goes along with these two. One is materialistic perspective of life, another is spiritual perspective of life. And Quran gives parallel examples to these two perspectives, two idrakat. Those who rejected religion, they say, Wama hadhihi dunya, hadhihi hayati dunya illa namutu wa nahya, wama yuhliku nad-dahr. Suratul Jathiya, 45th chapter. What is this world? This world is nothing. We are alive, we will die. And it is a cycle goes on from millions, from hundreds of years. No need to worry about it. This is the ideology existing. Now, it is not something, we are smart now, we are in Canada, we are in the Western countries. Now the world is global village. We are. Religion is outdated. We no need to think about it. No. Quran says, these ideologies existed before too. The other perspective of life is a spiritual perspective, which says, no, this universe also is a responsible universe. وَلَهُ أَسْلَمَ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. It is going according to the norm, according to the fate which has been set goal for them. وَالشَّمْسُ تَجْرِي لِمُسْتَقَرِّ لَهَا ذَلِكَ تَقْدِيرُ الْعَزِيزِ الْعَلِيمِ. Today I want to talk about needs are three kinds. One is personal need in our individual life. The second is social need. A human being has to live. He is a social being. Number three is noble needs. In regards to personal life, individual needs, we need food, we need clothing, we need shelter. It is obvious. And for my individual life, if there is only one person on earth, then there is no need of any law. Once we have social norm, That means wife, children, neighbors, the society. So we need qanoon, we need laws. Because it's a society. Just like every day we have been asked to be careful neighbor, and his neighbor is very kind enough to give us the place, and it is very important to take care of his property, and we should respect. All of this, because we are social beings. Number three need, third need is noble need. What it means, noble need? Is it enough for us, we are here and we have to go back? We don't need to worry about it. But human nature compels us to think, what is my beginning? Where I was? What is the beginning of this universe? And what is going to happen to the end of the world? You have seen nowadays a science has been developed, excavating the land and seeing the past of ourselves. It is a science. Being the cities have been found under the land, under this earth. Villages have been found. And by looking at them, we are coming up with the theories, yes, the methodology of their life, how they used to live. You find thousands of pages of information in regards to this science. Why human being is concerned about his past? Why human being is concerned about his future? That is the answer comes here from the Quran. فَأَقِمْ وَجْهَكَ لِلدِّينِ حَنِيفًا Surah number 30, ayah number 30, Surah Ar-Rum. Turn your face towards the upright religion, Dine Hanif. What is this religion? فِطْرَةَ اللَّهِ الَّتِي فَطَرَ النَّاسَ عَلَيْهَا لَا تَبْدِيلَ لِخَلْقِ اللَّهِ It is based on human nature, human instinct. We have been made so, such. These questions pops up in our mind. We ask question, who am I? Where am I? Where I'm going? What is this environment? Even those who say, I am an atheist, that means they realize something is inside, they are rejecting. Although they are saying, I don't believe in religion, that itself is a religion. No name product is also name. If you say no name product, that means there is a name also. That if you go to the market, what name is it? It's a no name product. So non-religion also a name. Atheism also a name. What is this fitra? Human nature? It is very important to know. Fitra is universal. Iqbal asks questions. Tere darya mein toofan kyun nahi hai? If you are an ocean, there has to be a movement. Tere darya mein toofan kyun nahi hai? Khud hi teri musalman kyun nahi hai? You might be a Muslim because my parents are Muslims. No, your will is not Muslim. Abbas hai shikwaye taqdeer-e yazdan to khud taqdeer-e yazdan kyun nahi hai? Why you are saying my fate, I have been born this way, this is my, I cannot do nothing. No, you take care of yourself, your destiny, and you write your own hands, haath ki lakeerein we call it. You can write your. What it means, it's a human being born with this fitra. I am free. Allah says, you are free. La ikraha fid din qad tabayyana ar-rushdu min al-ghay. There is no compulsion. You are free. Find a country where there is no laws. No, we don't have such country where there is no law. Each and every country there is law. There are laws to follow. So if there is no country more than 200 plus countries in the world, each and every country, they have their own laws. So there is no escape from the laws which is made by a human being himself. Islam says, simple question. I will give you an example for the youths. Now it is every 2-3 months, technology is changing. Every time a new phone, अभी आए अभी बैठे अभी दामन संभाला है तुम्हारी जाऊं जाऊं ने तो हमारा दम निकाला है. Three months before I bought it again, then they said new phone. What it is? It's a business. And when you buy a phone, there is a small booklet with it. That booklet is coming from where? From the same company which has produced that phone. I don't want to say the name. People might say, Maulana have, mashallah, his own share in that telephone company. It becomes commercial. No. You buy a phone, there is a small booklet. It's a manual made by whom? That is the same company. Human being is a so complex being and created by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, needs a manual. Who should be writing the manual of human being? Himself? The creator of human being. So that means I have to believe in Mabda. Mabda is beginning. There is no escape. I have to believe somewhere. Be serious, and I ask for the youths, please go and research. We are bombarded by saying, you have to believe in this theory of Big Bang theory. Widely accepted theory in the universities, in the colleges. Everyone says, Big Bang, there was one entity, this universe, there was a Big Bang, then one leads to the other, it became this universe. It's called Big Bang Theory. And another philosophy they teach, every cause has to have effect. Every effect has to have cause. My question, simple question to this Big Bang Theory is, if Big Bang is an effect, what is the cause of Big Bang? Show me. And you are the one, you are teaching me these philosophies also. I am not the one. Cause has to have effect, effect has to have cause. Big Bang is an effect and effect. And what is the cause of Big Bang? Listen, you write it down, this ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Big Bang has been taken from the Quran, but they took half of the ayat. They rejected the half. Suratul Anbiya. 21st chapter, ayah number 30. Quran is talking about Big Bang. أَوَلَمْ يَرَ الَّذِينَ كَفُرُوا أَنَّ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ كَانَتَ رَتْقًا. Non-believers, don't they see? This universe was one entity, one thing. This is the ayah. This is called, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, this entire universe was Kanata ratqa. Ratqa means one entity. Fafatakna huma. We caused them to explode. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says the Big Bang cause, if you cannot give, I am giving to you. I am the one who caused. Anna samawati wal arda kanata ratqa fafatakna huma. And after that, there is small ayat leading to this, concluding this ayat. وَجْعَلْنَا مِنَ الْمَاءِ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ حَيٍّ. With water we give life. Everything existing because of the water. Now, those who are exploring the universe, they are looking in the planet, nothing but water.
If any planet is gives us the idea there is water, that means there is a life. This is also taken from the Quran. And it is unfortunate, it's pathetic that we Muslims never explore, never work on it. Quran is encouraging humankind, Ya ma'ashara al-jinni wal-ins, in istata'tum an tanfudhu min aqtari samawati wal-ard, fanfudhu la tanfudhuna illa bi sultan, fa bi ayyi ala'i rabbikuma. So the Surah Ar-Rahman. Oh humankind, leave this land, man. कब तक चिपके हुए रहोगे यार निकलो यहां से कुरान से गेट आउट ऑफ हियर एंड गो एंड एक्सप्लोर द वर्ल्ड एंड आई हैव मेड दिस यूनिवर्स इन अ वे सखर लकुम अल्लाह अकबर सखर लकुम الشمس والقمر सखर लकुम الليل والنهار So that means this sun and moon is in our hand. You control it. Quran says, universe is under your control. So leave the land. Don't stick to this land. And find out. Go. Ya ma'ashar al-jinn wal-ins in istata'tum an tanfudhu min aqtari samawati wal-ard. Get out. But you need a power. La. You cannot go. Illa bi-sultan. With the power. So that means there is. That power has been indirectly has taught us there is, should be a power, you might be call it nuclear power, any power. There has to have something to go to the other planet. So my brothers, religion 1400 years before, for our conviction to have much more a clean in our religion. A person who lives in a peninsula at a time where is the utter darkness? Fi dalalim mubin. There was no such a thing, civilization. He never went to any university, any college. He has no teacher, but he comes up with the book which is so accurate. After 1400 years, no one can reject this book. Not a single word. Not a single letter. Alif Lam Mim, Dhalika al-Kitab, La Raiba Fihi, Hudal lil Muttaqin, Alladhina Yu'minuna bil Ghaib. So here comes the noble need of human being. Bear with me, it is very important. It's a very, very important for all of us, this nobility. What is nobility? Believing in someone who created me. So constantly we have been reminded, Big Bang Theory, Big Bang Theory. And the second thing is, you are from Bandar, is the theory of evolution. Constantly. We are teaching the children. Quran says, no, human being is so noble. Oh Iblis, ma mana'aka Allah tasjud. Why didn't you bow down to this Adam which I created. Khalaqtu biyadayya. I created with my two hands, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says. Allah has hand? No. Hand means power. Jamal and Jalal of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created. What made you not to do sajda to this person? I made him with my two hands. Means with the power of Rahmah, with Jamal and Jalal, with Adala and Rahma, you can call it more. Sallu alayhi. Wa Ali Muhammad wa Ajil Farajum. It is important for all of us to learn this small piece of Quran. The youths, please. Kuntum خَيْرَ أُمَّةٍ أُخْرِجَتْ لِلنَّاسِ تَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَتَنَهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ وَتُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ You are the best nation. Why I am best? Because you have nobility. What is that nobility? You believe in Mabda, the beginner. Who is the beginner? اللَّهُ خَالِقَ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ ربنا الذي أعطى كل شيء خلقه ثم هدى. Pharaoh asked, Musa and Harun, come here, why did you? You are challenging my power, man. I am super power. I can kill you, I can smash you, I can do anything. You are here to challenge my power? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked, Musa and Harun, two brothers, idhaba ila Fir'aun, go to Fir'aun. Innahu tagha, who exceeded the limits. What is the limit he exceeded? He is saying, me, no God, me, astaghfirullah. Ana rabbukumul a'la. Ana rabbukumul a'la. And provided Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, warning Hazrat Musa and Harun, your approach should be, it's a beautiful approach. What is approach? وَقُولَ قَوْلَ لَيِّنَا Surah Taha. When you go to Fir'aun, your communication skills should be a very beautiful skills. And we are living in the Western society, we call it the communication skill is very important. These skills we have to learn how to say something in a beautiful manner. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, even in front of Fir'aun, when both of you are going, remember these skills. Don't be harsh upon him. قُولَ لَهُ قَوْلًا قُولَ لَهُ قَوْلًا Oh, two brothers, talk to him with very soft tongue, soft communication. With Fir'aun? So that means Allah is teaching for us, those who are living in superpower in America, in Canada, in European country, when you are here, learn this language of layin. It is an ability. What is layin? A smooth presentation. That's why in media, our people is very important. And even writers are very important. But these people, their reading skills are very beautiful. We don't read books. But the Western countries, They are good readers. But unfortunately, they read for the enjoyment, fictional stories, because they have been put into such situation. So we have to explore ourselves. Our youth should come up with the books which can attract them in a direct, indirect manner, so that they can come to the conclusion there is a mabda, there is a beginner, who is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Salawat par Muhammad. Muhammad wa ajjil farajahum. Nobility and fitra. Fitra is universal. Universal means no time limit, no space limit, no age limit. For example, mother's love towards the children is fitra. Before the birth of a child, you need no need to give a class how to love this child. No, it is a fitra. That is called fitra. Maulana, some having this fitra, they buried alive their girls. Now we have to explore why they did so. When we see, dars is fitra, going to class, going to school, going to colleges, university, is a fitra of human being, acquiring knowledge. At the same thing, the same time, going to a sports arena and playing also a fitra, if one takes over the other, then is the problem. Why did they kill the fetus? Why did they kill the newborn girls? إِذَا بُشِّرَ أَهْدُهُمْ بِالْأُنْثَى ذَلَّ وَجُهُ مُسْوَدَّ وَهُوَ قَدِيمٌ Whenever the good tidings of birth of a baby girl has been given, they used to feel so furious, uncomfortable, living with this ungraceful life, having a girl. We thought they were in Fidal Ali Mubin. Today, after this
scanning system after this so-called ultrasound. In India, within 30 years, more than 30 million girl fetus has been removed from the mothers. It is a statistic in India. One day I was reading newspaper in India, buy one, get one free. The top says heading, buy one, get one free. When I started reading that article, the future is going to come. You have to marry one girl and you have to have another husband. That much shortage will be in India. So, are we so-called smart? We are now, mashallah, technological advancement is so fast. Within no time, while I am reading, you can message to New Zealand, you can message to Europe or Africa, anywhere you go. You can show also that world becomes global village. In such a time, human being is same, nothing has changed. The brutality of human being today in Western countries, every day millions of fetus has been removed from their mother's womb. And we call it freedom. We call it, we cannot, if it, she has a freedom, she has a free will. Islam says no, life cannot be taken away. Even that fetus has rights. Salwa for you. On the day of judgment, بِأَيَّ ذَنْبٍ قُتِلَتْ. Even fetus shall ask, what I have done, what I make mistake, why did you take away my life? What I have done wrong? I hope you are coming along with me and understanding what I am trying to present to you. Religion, we cannot escape from it. Religion, part and parcel of human life. If we do not follow Islam, we are following something. That something is becomes your religion. That's what Quran says, إِنَّ الدِّينَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ الْإِسْلَامِ. In the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, recognize religion is Islam, who is the creator. When Hazrat Musa and Harun, they went in front of Fir'aun, they said, Fir'aun said, who is your Lord? Man rabbukuma, man rabbukuma. The answer is, Rabbuna alladhi a'ata kulla shay'in khalqa thumma hada. Our Lord, the one who has given life to everything, each and everything. Then not only He has given life, He has guided us. Two things. Creation and guidance. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فَذَكِّرْ إِن نَفْعَةِ الذِّكْرَ فَذَكِّرْ إِنَّمَا أَنْتَ مُذَكِّرْ لَسْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ بِمُسَيْطِرْ. Prophet's job is to remind, that's it. Hidayat is not our job. Even an alim cannot impose, for example, oh, this is it, you have to believe, you have to believe. That means that is blackmailing. No, I cannot do that. I can present to you too. You can choose what is right. If I am talking logic, it is going to go inside your system. Quran says, creation and hidayah belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nobody created. Creator is Allah. Not only creator is Allah, and also guidance also comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَنْ يَهْدِ اللَّهِ فَلَا مُضِلَّ لَهِ. Imam Hussain alayhi salatu wasalam, we are commemorating these days, and while we are here, it is unfortunate. My heart bleeds. Our Jummah is gone. Our Salatul Jamaat is gone. What we have made mistake? What mistake we have done? We don't know. Sometimes I cry, رَبَّنَا لَا تُؤَخِذْنَا إِن نَسِيْنَا وَأَخْتَعْنَا. Something we have done wrong. It's a very, very important thing in our life is Jummah. Al-Jum'ah حَجُّ الْفُقَرَى. If anyone who cannot go to Hajj, the best is to go to Hajj, Jummah. That much importance of Jummah, that Jummah is not now. So we have to cry, we have to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, forgive us.
Something we have done wrong. This beautiful thing has been taken away from us. And Imam Hussain is coming to this conclusion when he goes to the Walid, the governor of Medina, Lanatullah Alayh. He clearly says, my fikr, my ideology, when he mentioned Amir-e-Sham has passed away, Imam immediately said, Kalmatul Istirja, Inna Lillahi wa Inna Ilayhi. That was the answer of Imam Hussain. Never needed nothing else. On the other hand, Yazid is sitting on his chair, throne, and he's saying what? La'ibad banu Hashim fala ja'a khabarun wala wahyun nazal. This is Bani Hashim. He said, not Islam, nothing. It is Bani Hashim. That means Bani Umayya, Bani Hashim. Two families. Bani Hashim, they played a game. There was no wahi, there is no Quran, there is no God, nothing. And he is proclaiming his Khalif of Allah. Astaghfirullah. So someone has to challenge his authority. Imam Hussain says, Ayyuhal Amir, Nahnu ahlu baytin nubuwah wa ma'danu risalah wa makhtalaf al malaikah wa mahbat al wahy wa al tanzil bina fatah Allah bina yakhtamu. If you want to know beginning, it comes from us. And then the end of this universe also is going to end with us. That is the challenge. We have to understand the Karbala in these lines. Sallallahu alayka ya Aba Abdullah. Mawla Imam Hussain's caravan is getting closer. On the way, Zuhair bin Qain, Mawla Imam Hussain ko avoid kar raha hai. He's one of the companions of Prophet Muhammad. Magar ek aisa maqam aaya jab umar jab jaate the log voyage mein desert mein padav dalne ke liye, to have a stopping they have to have water, to aisi jagah talash karte the jahan pani ho, ek jagah pani ho. Aur Zuhair bhi aur Maula Imam Hussain khayme nasb ho gaye. Imam Hussain ne apne emissary ko bheja se Zuhair ke paas jaake baat karo, usse kaho main bula raha hu. Allahu Akbar. Mawla hame bhi bula lijiye. Aise anana. Zuhair ke paas emissary aa raha hai, to malum something is in him. Imam Hussain keh rahe hain usse bulao. Zuhair jab aaya, the reporters, Ravi kehte hain, Ravi main aajkal ki language mein we can say reporters. وہ mention کرتا کہ جب داخل ہوا زہیر امام حسین کے خیمے میں tent میں, he was not comfortable. His face is telling something is wrong in him. اندر گئے کیا گفتگو ہوئی نہیں معلوم. جب باہر آیا ہے زہیر, ایسے معلوم ہوتا کہ عبر کو ہٹا کر کے چاند نکل رہا. وہ یہ decide کر چکا تھا. تو معلوم ہے جب تک religion انسان کے پاس نہ ہو, path set na ho, insan mutmain nahi ho sakta. Contentment nahi aata uske zindagi mein. Bahar jab nikalta hai to ghar mein apne khayme aata hai, apni zauja se kehta hai ki tum ghar ko chale jao, wapas jao Kufa chale jao, isliye ki maine tay kar liya ki Hussain ke saath jaao. Assalamu alaikum ya ansar deenillah. کہ کس کے انصار ہیں یہ لوگ؟ دین کے انصار ہیں, حسین کے نہیں. السلام علیکم یا انصار رسول اللہ. یہ کس کی نصرت کرنے والے ہیں؟ Who are these people helping whom؟ کہ رسول اللہ کو مدد کرنے والے. اور یہی پر رکی نہیں, ہم لوگ شیعہ حضرات بچہ گرتا ہے تو کہتے ہیں یا علی. یہ ہماری عادت ہے, یہ ہمارا نارم ہے. مولا علی کو مشکل کشا مانتے ہیں. علی کی مشکل کشائی کرنے والا کون ہے؟ زیارت. السلام علیکم يا انصار امير المؤمنين. الله اكبر. اب اندازہ کیجئے کہ کتنے مقام ہیں انصار امام حسین کے. اس کے بعد میں کہتا ہوں کس کی مجال ہے وہ پاک بی بی کی مدد کرے, چکی چل رہی ہے اس کے ہاتھ میں ہاتھ لگا دے, لیکن یہاں پر زیارت رکتی نہیں ہے. آواز آ رہی ہے السلام علیکم یا انصار فاطمۃ الزہرا. اے فاطمہ کی مدد کرنے والوں. تو زہیر اپنی زوجہ سے کہتا ہے تم گھر چلی جاؤ. گو بیک ٹو ہوم. اور کیوں؟ اس لیے کہ وہ نواسے رسول ہیں, نواسے رسول ہیں, اور جب نواسے رسول ہیں تو لوگ عزت سے احترام سے دیکھیں گے ان کو. اگر سم تھنگ ہیپنس, کچھ ہوتا ہے وہاں پر, ان کے بیوی بچوں کو, اہل حرم کو لوگ عزت سے ان کے مقام پہ پہنچائیں گے. تم کو کوئی پہچانتا نہیں ہے, نو بڑی نوز یو, کہیں تمہاری بے حرمتی نہ ہو جائے, بہتر ہے کہ تم چلی جاؤ واپس. بس ہو گئی مجلس. تاریخ کہتی ہے کہ واقع کربلا کے بعد جب 11 محرم کو کربلا سے قافلہ پہنچا کوفے, کوفے میں بھگدڑ مچی. زہیر کی زوجہ نے اپنے غلام سے کہا جا کر دیکھو کوفے میں کیا آوازیں ہو رہی ہیں. غلام جاتا ہے, تھوڑی دیر بعد واپس آتا ہے, بی بی قیامت ہو گئی, بہت قیامت ہو گئی. کیا ہو گیا؟ تو مولا حسین کی شہادت ہو گئی, امام حسین شہید ہو گئے. زہیر کی زوجہ نے گریہ کیا. اس کے بعد نہ جانے دل میں کیا خیال آیا, وہ اندر گئی, جا کر کے صندوق سے کفن لایا, غلام کے ہاتھ میں دیا. کو نواسے رسول تھے, ان کو لوگوں نے غسل دیا ہوگا, ان کو لوگوں نے کفن پہنایا ہوگا. میرے شوہر کو کوئی پہچانتا نہیں تھا, جاؤ کربلا جا کر کے میرے شوہر کو غسل و کفن دے دو اور دفن کر کے واپس آ جاؤ. حر تاریخ کہتی ہے کہ زہیر کی زوجہ کے کہنے پر زہیر کا غلام نکلتا ہے کوفے سے. اس زمانے میں حساب لگاتے تھے اتنی دیر جانے کے لیے, اتنی دیر واپس آنے کے لیے, اتنی دیر اس کام کے لیے. وہ لگا رہی ہے حساب, ابھی آنا چاہیے اس کے غلام کو. دق الباب ہوا, ناک ہوا ڈور, ایک مرتبہ دوڑی بھی پہنچی, غلام سے کہا تو نے میرے شوہر کو غسل دے دیا, کفن پہنا دیا, ہاتھ میں کفن واپس لایا ہے, کبھی بھی میں نے ایسا کر نہیں سکا. کہا کیوں نہیں کر سکے, جبکہ میں تم کو, میں نے حکم دیا تھا اور میں نے تم سے کہا تھا کہ تم یہ کر کے آؤ گے تو تم کو میں آزاد کر دوں گی. کبھی بھی من نہیں کر سکا. کیوں نہیں کر سکے؟ کبھی بھی من نہیں کر سکا, میں شرمندہ ہوں. کہ کیا وجہ ہے کہ تم نہیں کر سکا؟ کبھی بھی جب میں کربلا میں پہنچا, کیا دیکھا؟ نواز رسول کا لاشا بے گور و کفن کربلا کی ریت میں پڑا ہوا ہے. صلی اللہ علیک یا ابا عبداللہ وعلى الارواح التي حلت بفنائك واناخت برحلك عليكم من السلام ابدا ما بقيت وبقي الليل والنهار. السلام على الحسين وعلى علي بن الحسين وعلى اولاد الحسين وعلى اصحاب الحسين. فيا ليتنا كنا معكم فنفوز معكم فوزا عظيما. حدیث میں ہے کہ جب پڑتی ہوئی بارش ہو, پانی رین ہو رہی ہو, دعا قبول ہوتی ہے. چلے دعا کریں. پروردگار پہلی دعا یہ ہے, ان مرحومین کے برزخی حالات کو جان جو یہاں دفن ہیں, ہمارے مرحومین کے برزخی حالات کو بہتر سے بہتر کر دے, ان کو جوار ایمہ میں جگہ عنایت فرما. مالک ہمارے اور آئندہ آنے والے نسلوں کی ایمان کی حفاظت فرما. بدایا اس بیماری میں جو COVID-19 میں ممنین جو مبتلا ہیں یا کوئی انسان جو مبتلا ہے, مالک ان کو صحت کامل عاجلہ عنایت فرما. ہمارے جسمانی امراض کے ساتھ ساتھ روحانی امراض میں غرور و حسد و کبر و نفاق و نخوت و غیبت کو دور فرما. جو گودیاں خالی ہیں انہیں پر کر دے. جو لڑکے لڑکیاں بن بیاہ کے ہیں ان کی بیاہ کر دے. صفوف مسلمین کو متحد کر دے. ہمیں بانٹنے والی سہونی قوتوں کو بانٹ دے. پروردگارا مراجع رہبر کے سائے کو ہمارے سروں پر سلامت رکھ. پروردگارا انقلاب اسلامی کو انقلاب مہدی تک ملا دے. جلد سے جلد مولا کا ظہور فرما. ماتم حسین.